Hi friends, so this is the speed time curve we have already discussed in the previous video, but for calculation purpose we need to make it easier. So first, for easier calculations we need to change this curve to the simplified form, so with having least possible error. So how this graph is simplified without losing much data, let us see now. Actually this has been simplified like this, so the periods are, the coasting period is increased and the free running period is somewhat reduced. So let us see how this curve will be. Actually there are two types of simplifications for this. One is called trapezoidal speed time curve and second one is quadrilateral speed time curve. So first this will be like this. It is having, but without changing alpha and beta. So this is alpha, this is that one, this is acceleration period. Okay, this is acceleration period. So after that there should be free running period, that means it should be parallel to x-axis, but it is having some slant, it is having some slant, and finally it is reduced to, so here the braking is applied. So I can say that this is the simplified graph, I mean simplified speed time curve. So let me have some nomenclature. This is O, let me take this as A, B and C. Even I call this as the simplified thing, but still there are two more simplifications without changing much of these things. I mean without changing the area is very important. Actually we have kept the things constant here. For see what we have done here in this case. So simplification can be done to get the least error. How to get the least error? So simplification means definitely there should be some error, but that should be least. So this least error can be get without changing acceleration and retardation periods. These two periods are constant. So this is tan inverse alpha only and this is tan inverse beta only, and these two are not changed. And without changing the area means it is directly related to distance. So area means is distance only. So area under both actual and simplified things should not be changed and they should be same. In this way the graph should be converted into two more forms. One is trapezoidal speed time curve and second one is quadrilateral speed time curve, and let us see how they will be drawn. So first trapezoidal thing, so for trapezoidal thing I need to draw a line parallel to the x-axis. So first we need to go somewhat more here, and the line should be parallel to x-axis, so it should be like this. That's all. Should be like this and somewhat like this. Yes, so now I can take this point as A dash and this point as B dash. Now so OABC can be taken as actual curve. So now it will be O A dash B dash C, and this will be trapezoidal speed time curve. Here if you keep on seeing this, actually we are losing this part. So this part we are losing, and this part we are adding, and also this part we are adding. So this part will be equal to this part and this part, and the action, that means care has been taken in this way so that these two are approximately same. So now the actual curve has been converted into trapezoidal curve. So if you consider O A dash B dash C. Now we have one more thing also, that is called quadrilateral curve, and that will be like this. So the quadrilateral curve will be like this. So please see here, it is very clumsy. Yes, and you need to go somewhat more, and here also somewhat down. As this is sketch pen, I am unable to show you better. So this is A dash, A double dash, and this is B double dash. So this is the thing. So it is moved further. It is more than A dash. A double dash is moved more than A dash and before A only, and B double dash is less than, I mean just down to B. So this curve is called O A double dash B double dash C is called quadrilateral speed time curve, and these two are the simplified forms of actual speed time curve. And now let us see how these things will be done, that means how the distance will be calculated in trapezoidal speed time curve and quadrilateral speed time curve. Let us see now. Let us see trapezoidal speed time curve. Trapezoidal speed time curve. So the drawing is very simple, as this is a trapezoidal. So if we remember the things, trapezoidal means two sides should be parallel. So this is x axis, and if this is the y axis, so this is speed, this is time. And if you see trapezoidal, so two lines should be parallel, and one line is like this, this is for acceleration, one line is like this, this is for retardation or deceleration. So these two are never be parallel, because this is positive slope and this is negative slope, so they should not be parallel. Parallel means the slope should be equal. So which two can be parallel, and this line can be parallel with this line, that is only my option. So let me draw simply. This is for acceleration part, and this is parallel to my x-axis. This is it. So finally this diagram is very simple. This is my trapezoidal curve. Let me identify different parts here. Let me identify the times here. Yeah, this is, let me take this as time t1. From here to here it is time t2, and from here to here it is time t3. Let me take this as capital T. Okay, total time. And this part is tan inverse alpha, as we already discussed. This part is tan inverse beta. So this is a trapezoidal speed time curve. So two lines should be parallel. So x axis and this one is parallel. As we are making it parallel means we have only one speed, that is maximum speed Vm. Okay, this is very simple thing. So let me identify one more. Let me join these two. Even I can join these two also. So here let me identify some names O, A, B, C, D, E. Now, my job is to find out the speed distance D. Let me take the distance as D. Distance D. D-I-S-T, let me call, because this is already D, so this is distance. So how to find the distance? As we know, the distance is the area under the curve. So let me take the area of a triangle O-A-D, O-A-D, so this area, and this will be summed up with D-A-B, D-A-B. Plus B D C, so area B D C. So the entire area was covered now. So first I have covered this part. Now again next D A B, this part was covered. Next D B C or B D C, this area was covered. So entire area was covered. In some textbooks they have followed in the different manner. The job is to cover the entire area. So they may cover this triangle, they may cover this quadrilateral, or they may cover this triangle. That's all. Very simple. So whatever may be the thing, the answer will be the same. So that is that equal to triangle of OAD plus here DAB is exactly equal to DEB. So let me write D E B plus triangle B D C, which is equal to triangle O A D plus triangle D E B plus B D C will be equal to E B C. So it will be triangle E B C. So once this was completed, now our next step would be just calculating the area. How to calculate area of a triangle? So area of a triangle is half base into height. So in OAD it will be half base is OD into height is AE plus in EBC half EC is the base, BD is the height. So it will be half into OD means capital T minus, it is T1 plus T2, so it should be capital T minus T3 divided by, actually the speed is in kmph and the time is in seconds. So these are the things, but kmph means it is in hour. So definitely it should be divided with 3600. Okay, after that, not now. So this is the OD. OD is taken in T minus T3 in second. So what is AE? AE means it is VM. So VM is in kmph. So I need to convert into seconds. So it should be 3600. Plus similarly, half into EC means T2 plus T3, it should be capital T minus T1 into VM divided by 3600. That's all. This is the thing. But now I need to show you one thing. So in triangle OAE, what is tan angle? Tan of tan inverse alpha is equal to opposite side is AE, that is VM, adjacent side is T1, which implies alpha is equal to VM by T1, which implies T1 is equal to VM by alpha. Very simple concept. Therefore I can say that is for T1. So I can say similarly, T2 T3 is also equal to Vm by beta. So I need to convert this into by substituting these two equations. So before that, let me take them as common. So distance is equal to Vm is taken out as common, and 3600 is taken out as common, and even 1/2 is also taken as common into capital T minus, sorry, there are two T's, so 2T minus T3 means Vm by alpha, sorry, Vm by beta, and T1 is Vm by alpha. Okay, it's very simple thing. So now which is equal to Vm by 7200 into 2T minus again Vm into 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta. So here one constant has been introduced, that is called K, which is equal to 1 by 2 times of 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta. So now let us see if with this, if distance is taken as D, for example, so D is equal to Vm by 3600 will be like that, and 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So it will be capital T minus Vm into K, as K is 1 by 2 into 1 by alpha plus 1 by beta. Very simple. So this is the formula for distance traveled. Now let me see how I can find the maximum speed Vm. So it's very simple. It is 3600 capital D is equal to Vm capital T minus Vm square into K. Let me take Vm square here, Vm square into K minus Vm into T plus 3600 into D is equal to 0. But as we know, Ax square plus Bx plus C, the roots are very simple. The roots are minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So let us see what are the things here. Here the things are if that is the case here, for example, if ax square plus bx plus c, the roots means x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. If this is the case, let me compare all these things. Here x is equal to Vm, so a is equal to k into Vm square, that means a is equal to k, and b is equal to Vm into t minus t, so it should be minus t, and c is equal to 3600 into d. So substitute the same thing. X means Vm here, minus b, minus of minus it's capital T, plus or minus square root of b square means minus t whole square, minus 4 times of a means k into 3600 capital D whole divided by 2a means 2k. Therefore, I can conclude that Vm is equal to capital T plus, here plus sign is a very huge quantity, so we won't take plus sign here, we will take only minus sign here. So capital T minus square root of T square minus 14400 into D whole divided by 2K. So this is the formula for Vm, maximum speed. That's all, very simple. So this is the trapezoidal curve. First we need to identify how to draw trapezoidal speed time curve, and then how to apply, how to get the distance by taking triangles or quadrilateral or whatever it may be, simply the area under the curve. Once you have finished that, you need to apply what is alpha and what is beta, sorry, what is alpha, what is alpha and what is beta. Once these two are substituted, so you will get like this one, and finally you can identify distance D. Once you know the distance D, so you can easily find by using these things, by using quadratic equation formula, you can easily find the root of this formula, that is Vm. So Vm is equal to finally capital T minus square root of T square minus 14,400 D whole divided by 2K. So this is the explanation for trapezoidal speed time curve. If you have any doubts, you can write in the comment box. If I commit any mistake, please comment in the comment box. And please like the video if you like it. And kindly share this video with your friends and colleagues. And please do subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you. Thank you very much.